This video shows how to make the MCU controlled high current relay spot welder. It only has two main parts, and it's the simplest, most reliable, and very low cost. I tried three DIY spot welder solutions for my e-bike battery replacement. One of them is bought, and the other two are homemade. This video shows the third solution, which is also the best. The comparison of these three spot welder solutions can be found in my other video. First, let's have a look at the demonstration. The welding process is simple and easy. Put the nickel strip on the battery. Hold the two copper rods steady. Press the button on the board. The MCU outputs two poles. The high current relay turns on twice. The solder joints are very strong, as tested in the test welding. This is the system structure diagram. It's very simple. Apart from car battery and welding rods, there are only two main components: S-on-off SV control board and high current relay. The MCU ESP8266 on S-on-off SV outputs pulse to control the high current relay, which provides high pulsed current for spot welding. Car battery can provide high peak current for welding. Welding pen is made from copper rods, which can be bought online. The high current relay is rated at 80 amps. There may be not enough current margin of the relay, but for welding a small number of 18650 batteries at home, it's enough. I use S-on-off SV because I happened to have one. This board can be directly connected to a 12-volt power supply and provide relay output to directly control the high current relay. In addition, ESP8266 can run ESP Easy firmware, so that parameters can be easily adjusted through the web page interface. These two main components are cheap and can be easily sourced online. Wiring is very simple. The S-on-off SV input is connected to the 12-volt battery. The output of S-on-off SV is connected to the control input of the high current relay. Those two are small current control signals. No thick wires are needed. One of the load terminals of the high current relay is connected to the positive output of the battery. The other terminal is connected to the welding copper rod. Other copper rod is directly connected to the negative terminal of the battery. These two wires provide high current for welding and require thick wires. It is recommended to use 10 square millimeter cable. The brass radiator key has two holes and a pillow. One of the holes can be used to mount to the high current relay. The pillow is fixed to the battery with a hose clamp. Although I bought a car battery connector, but found that the hose clamp is better. The welding code is also very simple. I use the script for ESP Easy. It outputs two pulses when the button is pressed. The first pulse removes oxides on the surface of nickel strip. The second pulse welds the nickel strip to the battery. The last 5 seconds delay is to prevent duplicate triggering. Please note that a reverse diode should be added to the output of SON-OFF. This diode provides the return path for the current driving relay and reduces reverse voltage spike and interference. A1N4007 diode will do the job here. You may notice that the circuit lacks a fuse. It's because I don't have time to buy one. If possible, please add a 200 amp fuse. This is the test video before I weld the e-bike batteries. For single weld, it is already pretty strong. After second weld, it is very solid. You can't pull it off by hand. I have to cut the nickel strip off from the test battery. Under my test and experiment, the MCU controlled high current relay solution is most reliable, and it is also simplest and very low cost. I recommend this for all the DIYers. Please leave the comment below if you have questions. Hope this video is useful to you. Please click like and subscribe to support me. Thank you.